Friends, today we are going to talk about one of the type of cell division, that is mitosis. Now the term mitosis means thread-like. It is a Greek word which actually means thread-like. It specifically concentrates on the structure of the chromosome, which are at the initial stage of the cell division. Okay. Now, mitosis is the type of cell division which, you know, is also called as the equational division. It is a type of cell division which can also be called as equational division. The reason being, at the end of mitosis, the number of chromosomes in the parent cell and the daughter cells are equal. For example, to start with, if a particular cell has 2n number of chromosomes, as a result of mitosis, 2 new daughter cells will be formed and each of the daughter cell has the same number of chromosomes, that is 2n. The original cell was also diploid and the new daughter cells formed now are also diploid, and this is the reason mitosis is called as the equational division. Okay, it generally takes place in the somatogenic cells, or in common term what you tell are the somatic cells, right? Those cells, the complete cells of the body except for the germ cells, they will be called as the somatic cells. So these somatic cells, they generally undergo the type of division which is called as the mitotic division. This is because these are the cells which continuously have to undergo growth and repair. So if growth and repair has to take place, growth can be in terms of number, increase in the number of cells. Okay, so now the normal growth and repair when takes place inside the body, it should be checked that the number of chromosomes in the cell remains same. If the number of chromosomes will be reduced to half, then there will be imbalance, or you can say improper functioning of the cells. If it is taking place in gametogenic cells, that is the germ cells, it can only occur during the multiplication phase. It can only occur during the multiplication phase. You have studied about the process of gametogenesis, that is the process by which the germ cells are formed. Now there are sequence of events which take place during that germ cell formation. Okay, so there are different phases. One of those phases in the gametogenic cells is the multiplication phase. It is during this multiplication phase when the germ cells undergo the equational division or mitosis. Otherwise, the germ cells, for you know, becoming haploid, they will always follow the meiotic cell division or meiosis. Okay. So as I said, these are the common cells. Somatogenic cells are the common cells in which mitosis is found. In case of gametogenic cells, it will be only found during the multiplication phase, not in any other phase. Okay. Now the complete process of mitosis, you can say that it is divided into two stages. The first stage is called as karyokinesis. The term karyokinesis has again two words. One is karyon, that means nucleus, and kinesis means division. So, at the initial stage of the process of mitosis, what happens is only the nucleus divides. So that process is called as karyokinesis. The second part is cytokinesis. Here, it means cyto means the cytoplasm. And again, kinesis is division. So when the cytoplasmic division is taking place inside the cell, that process will be called as cytokinesis. And it is to be remembered that cytokinesis is always followed by karyokinesis during the process of cell division. Okay, so first only the nucleus, that you can say first the nuclear material, and then the nucleus is going to divide, and after the nuclear division has been completed, only then and then the cytoplasmic content will be divided. Okay, so you should know that Cytokinesis always follows cytokinesis always follows karyokinesis. So karyokinesis is the first process which takes place, and cytokinesis is the second process which takes place. Now we're coming to the equational division, you know, that diploid number of chromosome remains same. If you take example of the mammalian cells, mammals have total each and every human cell has total 46 number of chromosomes. 2n is equal to 46. So these 46 number of chromosome, or when a human somatic cell divides, the two daughter cells which are formed are also having 46 number of chromosomes. Now this is happening because before the cell enters into the cell division phase or the mitosis phase, it is going to undergo a phase which is called as interphase. One of the phase of the interphase is called as the synthesis phase or the S phase. Now during this phase, what happens is the concentration of the chromosome increases, or you can say double. That means total concentration of the chromosome is 2C, right? That is going to double, that is 4C. Whereas during the same phase, the number of chromosomes will remain same. That is 2N will remain 2N only. Now, how does these take place? If I say that the number of chromosomes is same, then how can the concentration of chromosome increase? When the cell is in S phase, the chromosomes are in the form of monads. That means single chromatids will be present attached to the centromere. This is the centromere of the cell, and these are the chromatids which are arranged, you can say the arms which are attached to the centromeres. Now, at the S phase, what happens is these chromatids, they divide from the center and form a structure like this. That means when we say that during the S phase, replication of the DNA is taking place, that replication or duplication of the DNA is resulting into the formation of the dyad structure of the chromosome. That means a single centromere having two sister chromatids attached to each other. These are nothing but the sister chromatids that are attached to the centromere of the chromosome. So earlier, before the S phase starts, the chromosome is a monad. That means it has only one chromatid attached to the centromere. Whereas at the end of the S phase, or during the S phase, the chromosome turns into a dyad. That means the centromere will show attachment with two sister chromatids attached to a single centromere. So this is all about the introduction of mitosis. Now we will be seeing that what actually happens in karyokinesis. When the nuclear division is taking place, or you can say the karyokinesis is actually again subdivided into four phases. The first phase of the karyokinesis in mitosis is called as the prophase. The second phase is called as the metaphase, third anaphase, and the fourth is telophase. So these are the phases during which together all these four phases will result into karyokinesis, and after karyokinesis is completed, what occurs next is cytokinesis. So in the next video, we will be studying about the each and every detailed stage of the karyokinesis. Thank you.